Good morning, students. Today we are going to begin with our second lesson, Michelangelo. Before starting with the lesson, let us see the author of Michelangelo. The author of Michelangelo is Gulzar. Let us see about Gulzar. The author of this story, Michelangelo, is Sampoorna Singh Kalra. Sampoorna Singh Kalra is, his pen name is Gulzar, is known as Gulzar. He is known for his poetry in Hindi, Urdu, Punjabi and other languages. He is an Indian writer. Okay, so he is an acclaimed lyricist for Hindi cinemas. So you might have seen his names in Hindi songs and all. Along with being an accomplished director, he has won recognition for his contribution to Indian literature as well as to the Hindi cinema. So he became a reputed writer. Gulzar worked as a, before becoming a reputed writer, he worked as a car mechanic. And now this particular story, what we are going to see over here, Michelangelo, is from the story Michelangelo and other stories. Okay, from there he has taken the story. Okay, and he has done this particular, he has presented this particular work in front of us. So let us begin with the lesson, Michelangelo. Let us begin with the lesson. 4 years had passed since Michelangelo's return from Florence and Rome was beginning to bore him. "You can't find faces in Rome," Michelangelo grumbled to Pope Julius. "There's no character in the faces here. They all look alike." So over here you can see 4 years had passed for Michelangelo's return from Florence. He came back from Florence, from this place called as Florence, and from Rome. So Rome was beginning to bore him. So after coming to Rome, he was feeling it as a boring place in the very beginning. Okay, you can't find faces in Rome. So he was unable to find any faces in Rome, which was matching to the artwork what he was trying to do. That was his difficulty. That was the difficulty that Michelangelo was facing over here. You can't find faces in Rome. So Michelangelo felt in Rome he couldn't find any faces which were matching to his work. The faces that Michelangelo required to complete his work. So Michelangelo grumbled to Pope Julius. So this he was telling whom? This he was telling Pope Julius. From this itself we can understand one thing. Pope Julius had assigned some work, some project to Michelangelo, which Michelangelo was unable to complete. Because why? Because he was not getting those faces what he expected. Okay, those faces what he expected in Rome, so that he can complete his work. So his work was incomplete. So this he was complaining to Pope Julius. "There's no character in the faces here. They all look alike." So this is what he says. So I can't find my character. Michelangelo says that he couldn't find his character in any of the faces, in any of the real faces of human being that he was searching all around in Rome. So he says they all look alike. So he says people in Rome all look alike. This is what he says over here. "And what do you see in my face?" the Pope asked, almost in jest. So here the Pope, as a, in a joking manner, the Pope said, "What do you see in my face?" So you can understand an artist's feeling over here, isn't it? An artist look at everything in the world in his art point of view. That is what you can understand over here. Michelangelo saw all human faces. In every human face, he was searching his characters, which he wanted to complete it in his art form. So that he was not getting in Rome. This was his problem. That is what he was sharing with Pope Julius. And Pope Julius, in a joking manner, he said, "What do you see in my face?" So he wanted to know what Michelangelo felt about Pope Julius. This he said jokingly. Okay. So let us move to the question's answer. Right hand side in the box, you have a question. Let me dictate the answer to this. What problem did Michelangelo face in Rome? The answer to the question is Michelangelo faced boredom in Rome because it seemed to him that there was no character in the faces of Rome. No character in the faces of Rome. Full stop. He believed that all faces in Rome looked alike and therefore they could not inspire his art. So that was the answer to this question. Let us move to the next paragraph. So here, without even a pause, the artist replied, "A burning candle." So this is what Michelangelo told to reply to the Pope's question. What was the Pope's question? What his face, what he saw in Pope Julius's face. So on this Michelangelo said, without even a pause, he said, a burning candle. Okay, without stopping, without waiting to think, Michelangelo gave the reply, a burning candle. So this is what he had seen in Pope Julius's face. Okay, he saw Pope Julius's face as a burning candle. So it took a minute for Pope Julius to understand the barbed words. So it took some time for the Pope to understand this stinging words of Michelangelo. It took some time for Pope Julius. It took at about a minute to understand those stinging, those sharp words which came and hit the Pope. Okay. So to understand the meaning of those words. So very meaningfully Michelangelo had given this particular phrase over here, a burning candle. Okay, to understand those words, it took a minute for Pope. "I think I know what you mean," he said finally. So this is what the Pope said. "I think I know what you really mean by this. I feel that what you are meaning by this is known to me." This is what the Pope said. He said finally with a smile. So with a smile, the Pope said. So from this, what you can understand is that the Pope was in favor of Michelangelo. He favored Michelangelo. That is why he trusted Michelangelo. That is why he had assigned a work to Michelangelo. This is what you can see up to here. Okay, let us move to the next slide. "I am just one more candle that burns at the altar alongside those thousand others," right? So this is what he says. Okay, "I am just one more candle that burns at the altar." Now what do you understand by the altar? Altar means the space in the church. In the church, the place very close to the altar, isn't it? Where the religious ceremonies are performed. The place very close to the altar, in the sense the idol which is kept over there. Okay, so very close to the altar. "I am just one more candle that burns at the altar." So I am a special candle, he says. Okay. A special candle, he says, that is one candle among those candles which are burning in front of this altar, he says. "Alongside those thousand others," right? So it's one and the same. So there are thousand other candles, and you know, at the altar, right in front of the altar, you see many, many candles. So I am just one among them. This is what he said. So Michelangelo was silent on it. Okay, so this is Pope's statement over here, what you can see. So Michelangelo was silent on Pope's statement over here. Then Angelo, the Pope continued, "For 4 whole years you have been looking for Judas. I can't believe that in this vast universe that the Lord has created, where no two faces look alike, you cannot find faces, cannot discover models, surely." So this is what Pope says. Angelo, he calls out to Michelangelo. The Pope speaks, okay, "For four whole years you have been looking for Judas." For whole 4 years you were searching, you were in search of Judas. So what do you understand from here? Pope had given him a painting work which Michelangelo was doing, and in that painting work he was doing some biblical references, biblical characters he was displaying. Okay, so now who is this Judas? Judas is a disciple of Jesus Christ, and Judas is the same person who betrayed Jesus Christ towards the end. So about that Judas, and Michelangelo was searching this Judas face all around. That is what you had seen earlier. that he was not finding such a face in any of the faces that he saw in Rome. So he was in search of a character who could be taken into consideration. Looking at that particular person, he could complete his artwork. Okay, that is painting work. He wanted to draw such a human being who was best fulfilled for this character of Judas. So he was in search of this particular character, Judas. So this is what you can see over here. So that is what Pope is asking him. So long you didn't find any such face which was resembling that of the character Judas. I can't believe that in this vast universe that the Lord has created, where no two faces look alike, you cannot find faces, cannot discover models. So this is what he's asking. I don't understand, he says, in this vast universe, in the whole of the universe that God has created, where no two faces look alike. You know that there are no two faces alike, isn't it? So why you can't find, according to Michelangelo, all the faces in Rome is similar, isn't it? So Pope says there are no two faces which are looking same. Then how come that you can't find a face which is best suitable for the character of Judas? This is what Pope is asking him. Cannot discover models. Surely he says, and over here it's paused. He stops over here. So what happens, why he stops, let us see in the next line. Before the Pope could finish, Michelangelo had walked out. Okay, so Pope was speaking these things. Before the Pope could complete his line, complete his talk, complete his sentence, Michelangelo just walked off from there. Michelangelo went away from there. That is what you can see over here. Okay, so that is why there is a pause over here. He stopped. Before the Pope could finish, Michelangelo had walked out. Then let us move to the next paragraph. Pope Julius looked pensively at the retreating back of his moody painter. 4 years ago, Pope Julius had commissioned Michelangelo for a special task to paint frescoes of important events from the Bible on the walls and the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. Now they were nearly done. Only the last judgment remained unfinished. So let us see. Pope Julius looked pensively. What do you understand by it? He looked very thoughtfully at the retreating back of his moody painter. So you know, Michelangelo, painters are always moody. That is what you can understand over here, isn't it? So retreating back, he turned himself and he walked out while Pope was speaking. So as he was backing Pope Julius, he just looked at his back when he was walking out of the place where they were standing. Okay, back of his moody painter. So moody painter means, what do you understand? The person who keeps on changing his mood is called as a moody paint person, isn't it? So here Michelangelo is a painter. That is why it is called as moody painter over here. 4 years ago, so before 4 years, Pope Julius had assigned this work to Michelangelo. Commissioned means given the task of this work, this particular job of painting. Painting where Michelangelo for a special task. So painting the Sistine Chapel. Okay. So he was given the task of completing the work. Michelangelo for a special task to paint frescoes. Now frescoes means it is a type of painting made on moist surface. This is called as frescoes. Painting made on the moist surface, that is called as frescoes. You have learned this particular term in history also, the paintings made in olden times. Okay, these fresco paintings are not like what you have, the modern paintings. Okay, with the modern paints, they were not done. Okay, these paintings were made with natural things like the substances of the juices of vegetables, leaves, fruits were taken, and with the help of those juices they used to paint. So such paintings are called as frescoes. So natural paintings, you can call it out, it's not made with any sort of paint. They are all natural colors. With the natural things they used to paint. And you know, these natural colors, they remained, they were very good paints, right? They remained for forever. So that is what you can understand about frescoes. You have learned this term in your history, last year's history text. So frescoes of important events from the Bible. So these paintings which were assigned to him were the important events from the Bible, important stories of the Bible, okay, on the walls and the ceiling of the Sistine. And where he was supposed to do this painting, he was told to do this frescoes on the walls and the ceilings of the Sistine Chapel, of this particular chapel, Sistine Chapel, okay. What do you understand by chapel? Chapel means it's a small church. Church is a large area wherein you can accommodate a huge crowd, right? Crowd of people. So here a chapel means it will be a small place, a small area wherein few families will be getting together for prayers. So such a place is called as a chapel. So Sistine Chapel. So at this, so you can't call it, it is a church, but it is a small church, you can say. Okay. So now they were nearly done. So nearly, these paintings were nearly done by now. He had almost done. He had found all his other characters, but he was stuck with one. You know what it is. That is the character of Judas. He was stuck with that. He didn't get this particular character. Remaining everything he had already done over here. Only the last judgment remained unfinished. Okay, so last judgment. You might have seen in the picture of the last judgment almost everywhere, right? So the last judgment remained unfinished. So this particular picture remained unfinished. It was not completed. So why it was not completed? Because he was not getting the face of the character Judas to fulfill this particular painting. Okay, the last judgment, painting of the last judgment. That is why he didn't complete his work. So let me wind it up to here, and we'll continue in the next class. Thank you very much.